Hello, hello. So today we're going to be taking a look at the apron area of an airport and some of the work that takes place when a plane is on the ground at an airport. So let's begin with the apron area itself. This is where aircraft are normally parked, loaded, unloaded and refueled. You may also hear this area be called the ramp. The apron is normally separated from the taxiway by two solid white lines. Now, at small airports, this might be all that defines the apron area. Sometimes you may not see any more markings on the apron itself. If this is the case, then planes are usually guided to a parking spot or stand by a marshaller on the ground. Now, you'll have to forgive my stickman artwork here, but here are some common signals that a marshaller will give to a pilot. When they want a pilot to drive straight, they will raise both arms out to their sides at shoulder height, and then lift them above their heads and repeat this motion as long as they need the pilot to taxi straight ahead. If they need the pilot to turn left, from the pilot's perspective, they will hold out their right arm at shoulder height and move their left arm in the same motion as before, moving it from shoulder height above their head and back again. If they need the pilot to turn right, again for the pilot's perspective, then they will hold out their left arm steady and move their right arm up and down repeatedly. When they want the pilot to stop, they will raise both arms from shoulder height above their head and then cross their arms, forming an X above their head. So those are the four most common signals that you'll see. There may be slight variations on those movements, and there are other hand signals to give pilots additional instructions as well. So if you're interested in learning more, I'd recommend doing a quick search online for aircraft marshal signals. But for this video, let's keep things moving forward. Once a plane has parked and turned off the engine, a pilot will let the apron staff know when it's safe to approach the plane. They do this by turning off the plane's red beacon light. Once the light is out, ground staff and their various vehicles will approach the plane and begin working, doing such tasks as opening the cargo doors and setting up mobile staircases, for example. Now, there are a couple of rules for vehicles moving around an apron. The only strict rule is that ground vehicles must not pass over the double white line and enter the taxiway. Any vehicle, whether it is an aircraft or a ground vehicle, must contact air traffic control before entering a taxiway. I believe that all ground vehicles must also have a yellow flashing beacon light when driving. The rest of their work is simple common sense. For example, driving slowly, driving around the plane and don't try to drive under it, and also looking out for passengers walking around the plane, etc. At large airports, this whole process doesn't change that much. However, there are some more markings on the ground which allow planes and ground vehicles to do their respective jobs more effectively. Let's start with looking at the aircraft again. Some airports will have a taxiway center line which guides a plane all the way to the parking spot, which is also called a stand. Alternatively, you may see an arrow indicating the location of the parking spot. In both cases, the airport will have numbered parking spots and the number will be painted on the taxiway to help pilots identify the correct stand. You will also see a sign at the front of the stand confirming the number. The parking area or the stand itself will usually be a square shape, which is large enough to accommodate the wingspan of a plane. Now, depending on the airport, there may still be a marshaller who guides the planes precisely onto the stand. But at major airports, they're likely to have a visual docking guidance system, which allows the pilots to precisely park the plane themselves without the need for a marshaller. This is usually an electronic display at the front of the stand. However, I'm not going to talk about this in detail because there are many different versions of these guidance systems in use across the world. Now, for ground vehicles, you can get additional markings for each stand around an airport. Major airports contain a lot of ground vehicle traffic, so to ensure that vehicles move about in a safe, efficient and orderly manner, airports usually have their own road systems, and these work almost exactly the same as a regular road system. You'll have regular road markings, traffic lights, one-way systems and speed limits. Now, to improve the efficiency of ground operations, many ground vehicles are actually parked at a stand so that they are immediately available to work on an aircraft. so near the front of the plane, you may have some ground vehicle parking spots as well. And finally, larger airports often have a structure called a passenger boarding bridge. This is a movable bridge structure which is connected to the main terminal building and can be connected to an aircraft which is parked on the stand. You may also hear this be called a jet bridge or a jetway. On the ground, there may be an area marked out for the jetway, which should always remain clear so that the jetway can be moved up to and away from the plane while it's parked. So that just about covers the basics of aprons at an airport. For my next video, I'll be taking a look at the Flight Director feature, which you'll find in many aircraft, so stay tuned for that next week. But for now, thank you all very much for watching, take care out there, and I will catch you all later.